you'll hear a lot of people talking about pressing or pushing the ball, and it's basically just pushing your racket face directly in the direction that you want the ball to go, not swinging in a semicircle. So this can be really effective if your opponent is out of position, or even if your opponent is still in position and you're out of position, and you need to push the ball back down the wall, and just to make sure it's nice and tight, and you just want to recover, or, you know, things like lobs, or even if you just want a bit of a break and you want to push the ball down the wall a bit, and keep it high and tight. And this can be used to your advantage, but it is quite a hard thing for some people to do, is pushing the ball. The best way to practice it that I find is setting yourself up by the service box, and there's the line that goes across the service box. I'll show you in a little video in a minute. And on the service box, well, it's just below me actually, and you've got your box and you've got your line that goes across the court. In that little square where the lines meet, you're going to try and hit the ball against the front wall and push your racket forwards and try and hit that little square. The good thing about this exercise is that you've got the line to use as a guide so that your racket can follow the line. So you want to keep your racket so that your racket face is 90 degrees either side of that line. If it's coming off that line and your racket face is coming back, then you're not really pushing the ball. So use the line as a guide to keep your racket face going straight. When I first tried to do this, I found myself coming back and my racket face was opening up a lot. And I was pushing the ball around a lot more. I wasn't quite getting it straight. And then when I just practiced without the ball, push the racket face along the line, drop the ball down, push the ball forward, and try and keep the racket going in the same pattern. So try not to do circles, try and push it backwards, forward, so you're following the line through the where you would hit the ball, so it's going back, forward. So your start and finish are roughly the same. This helps create that push. So when you're really in position to really just push the ball into, say your opponent's out of position, right? And they're at the back of the court and you're at the front, and all you can do is just push the ball to the front corner, like a front drop or something like that. Super easy, just push the ball in there, don't have to do anything flash. So it's really good for that. And even if the ball comes at you and it comes flying at you and your opponent is out of position, and you're on the tee, and they're at the back, and the ball flies at you, you're still able to volley the ball and just push it into position. It's a really good technique for when you're out of position and in position. It's such a good way to create a winning point or get back into the game so you can create another winning point. So the push or press is such a good tool in the game of squash. So I'll show you a video and I'll show you me doing the drill. So I would practice this every day. Every day practice this drill. It's a drill for hand coordination, and it also helps with timing as well. So it's just like doing your volleys off the wall and getting really good timing. But obviously you're going to do this one off the bounce just to mix it up a bit. But the thing with doing it off the bounces is that you can use that line to help give you a visual on what you're doing with the racket face. So give it a go and see how you go.